Hello, I'm Lynn Morgan, and I create pastel paintings. I inherited my desire to make art from my mother. She went to the Parsons School of Design in New York City. She was studying fashion design, but then when the crash of 29 came along, she wasn't able to continue with that. But I still have some of her paintings and drawings and sketches in notebooks, and they're very inspirational to me. I always loved to draw when I was a kid. In fact, one of my favorite things to do was to take the bus to downtown Detroit by myself, if you can imagine that, and go to the big department stores to look for drawing paper. My mother even gave me a set of pastels when I was a kid, but I never really used them because, well, she was my mother and I didn't really always pay attention to what she was telling me to do. She actually wanted me to be a secretary, and I knew that I didn't want to do that, but I didn't know what I really did want to do. So I went to college, and I took one painting class, but it was an elective, and everyone else in the class was an art major, and I was so intimidated by all those art students that I stopped going to class. And the instructor couldn't fail me because I actually did complete all of the assignments. But it was the only D I ever got in school. So I got a degree in education and I taught school for 2 years. And then I worked at a big company in the human resources area for 35 years. During all those years, I still painted as a hobby, but I also learned how to do a lot of other things like playing the piano and the guitar, golf, scuba diving, flying an airplane, sailing. But when I was approaching retirement, I asked myself, what was the one thing that I always loved to do and really wanted to come back to? And it was art and painting. So I decided that when I would retire, I would make a commitment to becoming an artist and I would not fail for lack of trying. So I started taking art classes at the local junior college. And up until this point, I had been painting in acrylics and also watercolors. But one of my instructors at the junior college had me do a painting with some of her pastels, and I loved it, and I was hooked, and it's been my medium ever since then. So I started taking classes at the Armory Art Center and the Lighthouse Art Center, and I also started taking workshops with artists that I really admired. When I retired, I decided to make that commitment and spend 5 days a week working on my art. After about 2 years, I thought my art was good enough to show, so I hosted an open house. And I rented champagne glasses and plates, and I got food. And as each person came in the door, I had a glass of champagne for them. And I hung my art around the house, and I labeled it all very professionally. And I sold my first painting at that open house. I began to realize that getting a BFA degree was not that important, that what I really needed were contacts in the art world. So I joined some local art organizations, and then I decided to expand to regional and national art organizations. At this point, I am now a signature member of Women in the Visual Arts, the Boca Museum Art Guild, the Florida Artists Group, and the National Association of Women Artists. And through those organizations, I have exhibited a lot and won a lot of awards for my work. So I'll leave you with this thought, that like any other skill, you really have to practice to be good at it. So whether it's art or some other passion that you might have, make a commitment to it and don't give up. Thank you.